Hey guys, welcome back to some more AFK Arena. Today we're over on the pay to win account, and unfortunately it is sad to go guys, but the Abyssal Expedition beta version is about over. I know it is already quiet time, so the balancer is going to survive another day, but today we're going to take an in-depth look on exactly what team comps worked within the formations, because we know the Vault of Time, again, this was the beta version. It is going to be done. Quiet time has begun and the event has been concluded, guys. But we're going to take a quick look at the team comps that we utilized most to kill the balancer. All right, guys. So here we have it. Big shout out to the AE crowdsourcing Discord server, Reddit, AFK, and of course, Carbon for putting all of this together, guys. It is just a massive collaboration, as you can see here, of the skills and abilities of the heroes that we had. I want to see exactly what it's going to look like. So some of the top team comps, as we can see here, Lucretia and Grez were one of the very top tiers on 3.2 billion damage, guys. So essentially, when you come into the Abyssal Expedition, you have your first two teams. When you drop those two teams out, you put them in there as the actual heroes that you're going to build, depending on the relic choice that you're going to build. The third team in there should be a dedicated team to really being successful when it comes to the boss fights, and that is where the Lucretia team comp did come in. We have Lucretia and Grez with plus 30 signature items, the 9 of 9 furniture, as you can see here, fully maxed out within this formation. One of the most interesting heroes that I've seen in this combination is looking at Hodgkin right here. Very strong showing when it came to the Abyssal Expedition. Remember last one, he was not here. Since he's been introduced, he has been here. Mortis as well, of course, has been one of the best boss killing heroes, I guess. So this formation definitely worked, and a lot of players went with the Celerity. So as you can see here, it did go with the 505 Celerity. So that is almost completely max out Celerity. Good thing is, remember with our special little relic soul, you can just drop it on one hero, which they probably chose to use on Grez, not building out that tree and then focusing on developing the support tree as well. You can see most of these combinations are pretty similar to this combination. There's a ton of variations, and that is what I absolutely love about this, is the amount of data that is collected here. To do 3.2 billion damage in a formation definitely takes a lot of time, takes a lot of testing. It also has to ensure that we can do the most damage that we can. Remember, guys, the next Abyssal Expedition is going to be live. It is going to be the real one. These are the team comps that the top guilds are playing and running in AFK Arena. So next one we look at, which was tested, was Raku and Grez. 1.9 billion, so not quite the 3.2, but definitely a strong showing. Grez, look at the amount of places, guys, that Grez is literally showing up pretty much everywhere. Also looking at the core heroes that I really tell you to focus on, which are, of course, Mortis and the Twins. So out of the event that's going on right now, getting Mortis up to Elite Plus, getting the Twins up to Elite Plus at a minimum, really makes a big, big difference when it comes to how much progression and how fast you're going to make progression in AFK Arena. One of the reasons why we say to build them out earlier, just because they do utilize a lot of team comps. And same with Grez. Grez is utilized a ton of different places. Run through some miscellaneous, 1.3 billion. Thaewyn didn't have as strong as a showing. She was very strong in the last Abyssal Expedition, but not too prevalent in this one. Same with Zekas, the relatively new hero. Again, didn't see a very strong showing. And also Drez, guys. Drez was a hero back in some of the previous Abyssal Expeditions, was just absolutely dominating when it came to the progression they did here. As you can see, we do have a whole entire section dedicated to Drez and how effective he is within these comps. Down here, running without Mortis. So even just looking at the combination of this, guys. So on the top, we ran this with Mortis. On the bottom down here, there was no Mortis. going from 3.2 billion to 1.3 billion really shows you the raw power that Mortis brings to Team Cups, guys. When he is present and when he comes as a buffer, short of the Twins, there's probably not even another hero that can come close to what he can do when it comes to buffing. So if you're looking to make any progression, if you're looking to really maximize the damage you're doing within the Abyssal Expedition, guys, you have to build Mortis at least to Elite Plus so you can get him in there. Because again, you can see exactly how strong it is going to be. Without Mortis, again, team comps do suffer a little bit. And these were 5.6, 5.6. So these were maxed out in its entirety, guys. Again, completely maxed out with both of the trees there, as well as Grez running the Relic Soul within that formation. Now, look at the teams without Grez. Another thing I want to point out, not running Grez in formations. Look at the numbers. Look at the difference in the sheer amount of damage that you're doing to the boss here. We have Grez up here at 2 billion. We have no Grez down here at 500 million. The crazy difference that it takes when you're running Grez, when you're really building him out, it makes a huge difference, guys. Grez is another hero you absolutely have to have. And we've actually seen him through multiple Abyssal Expeditions that has performed super well. So looking at just a couple other formations, and the green is actually the Celerity tree. We'll see the Might is orange, and I believe the Sorcery tree is this purple color. So again, running no Twins dramatically changes the damage output that you're putting out on bosses. Even running with a strong boss killing comp, even here running the Relic Soul on, running it on Soris while we have the rest of the heroes built up with Relics, didn't do anything close to what we needed for damage, guys. But remember, the Lucretia Grez combination, while it is one of the strongest, you only have a certain amount of stamina. So there is going to be a point where you're going to have to rely on a couple formations outside of just the Lucy and Grez combo, because again, you're going to be limited by the stamina. So you do actually have to have two or three backup formations to make sure that you get to the boss. Once you're at the boss, it is really maximum damage, guys. It is literally throwing everything you can at the boss to try to burn him down as quick as possible. And really, depending what role you have in the Abyssal Expedition, if you're there to kill all the adds, if you're there as a pather, depending what role you play in the Abyssal Expedition also makes a very big idea of how you're going to play. Down here we have Raku, no Twins or Soris. So again, really minimizing the damage that we did there. And then Zekas and Theowyn as well with no Twins. Same with Drez, guys, not doing much damage at all. So let's go ahead and get into the Sorcery Tree. Again, a very sad showing, I guess, with the Sorcery Tree. Even looking here, guys, 1.1 billion damage, doing a billion damage here, but Lucy and Grez are putting up 3.2, which is absolutely just breathtaking, the amount of damage they can do. And of course, all of these combinations ran Grez again, guys. Cannot stress the importance of building out Grez, not only for the Abyssal Expedition, but always for the Twisted Realm. He is just utilized for everything. Even if you don't get that plus 30 signature item, that 9 of 9 furniture is a necessity. So looking down here, almost a billion on both of these running Isabella, and almost completely maxed out, guys. These were all maxed out Sorcery Trees, 5.6. And this is why we run these in the Abyssal Expedition, to make sure that we can see exactly the team comps that are running. The beta version is kind of a huge data analysis point that we look at in seeing exactly how strong they are. So looking at the Might Tree, not much data in here, but look at that, guys. 3.4 billion. So this was actually the very top team that we've seen within the Abyssal Expedition. Lucy Grez put up 3.2, Entendre Grez put up 3.4 billion damage, guys, which is crazy. The thing with the Might is you don't bring the dodge, so you don't actually have the dodge that the Celerity Tree brings, which makes a big difference when it comes to being able to take towers. So while the Might Tree might have put up a little bit more damage, The ability to take towns with the dodge that we bring from the Celerity tree does make a very strong difference. But again, as you can see, guys, all of these formations are running with Grez. Even up here, a pretty bad showing overall for sorcery because of the damage they're putting out. Now, this doesn't mean that Lilith is not going to change it when it comes to the next Abyssal Expedition. We might see a little change in the stats, a little change in the abilities in the sorcery tree or the might tree. We could see a little bit of nerf in the Celerity tree. It is yet to be seen exactly what we're going to do. So down here, very interesting, guys, solo heroes. These are heroes that went into the battle literally by themselves and have performed pretty well in the past. Drez has always done well. We have Thane doing well, which Thane has been kind of a broken hero that a lot of people have said. Plus 60 engraving, a lot of people are testing it out. They really think there might be some viability there. We're going to have to see. But look at the carry here. Is if you have one of these heroes such as Zekas or Thane, Setrena or Drez, with a considerable amount of stamina, you can solo the boss. You can actually do a considerable amount of damage, especially if you can get 5, 10, 15 attacks in. Doing 180 million per attack is pretty solid damage. So very cool to see with the solo teams. Then, of course, the duo teams doing almost half a billion damage there with Drez. So remember, the immunity that they're going to bring from Sylas and also the buff that he's going to give to Drez makes a very strong showing there. 500 million damage. So you're talking more damage than some of these teams. That is a five-man team comp. They're doing duo versus the balancer. Then, of course, we do have the trios. So now running three heroes within this formation. I'm not even doing as much damage as some of the trios are doing, but definitely not as much as the full team comps. So very interesting to see, again, all of the data collection that we have in here. It's kind of crazy. I'm going to put a link to the guide down below so you can check this out. But this is going to be an absolute giant point of reference, guys, when it comes to the Abyssal Expedition, when it actually comes out and is going to be the live version based on the leaderboards. So let me know in the comments what you guys think. And as always, thank you guys for watching.